Alright, man, this fucking thing is seeing fit to give me a goddamn heart attack. So, like, I just went through about, it's actually been about 15, shit, I left my drink out on the counter, damn it. It's been about 15 minutes since I started this, well, not 15 minutes, probably more like 8, 10, something around there since I started this shit up. Why did it take you 10 minutes to get to this screen, Nate? Well, let me fucking tell you why it took me 10 minutes to get to this goddamn screen. So I boot it up. It works properly. Everything's working fine. It's copacetic. I hit, you know, A. Let's log in. Let's go over to my display settings. Because when I switch over to a new, when I switch back and forth between recording and not recording, I have to, you know, plug in my HDMI cable to the live gamer portable. I got to use the composite, component cables that AverMedia provides you with the LGP in order to record off of the PlayStation 3. And so I have to set a different video setting so that it records properly. I gotta go to video settings, go down, change it from, it starts at composite, and I gotta change it to component, and then I gotta toggle 480i, 720p, 1080i, 1080p. And then after that, it goes to like this little screen that says, can you see this? If you can see this, press yes, and we'll continue onwards. If you cannot see this, then, you know, we'll wait until we revert back to the screen that you can see, and this just lets you know that you can't see this. And so for the first time ever since starting this, I went through all that, and it was just a black screen. The next screen did not pop up at all. So I'm sitting here like, that's weird. That shouldn't be happening. That's never happened before. Let's just unplug the login portal and plug it back in. You know, the whole IT person. Did you try turning it on and off again? That's what I tried. It didn't work. So then I tried turning my PlayStation 3 off and on again. It didn't work. Shockingly, after I did it twice, the screen at the very beginning, instead of actually going anywhere, stuck at a very bright shade of purple. It didn't show any text, didn't say, you know, these are the options, these are the profiles you may log into. It was just bright purple square, nothing more. So at this point, I'm kind of like, well, I'm freaking the fuck out now. I hope everything didn't break on me. What was the problem? What ended up being the problem? What was your solution to that? You know what the fucking solution is? The fucking composite cable was maybe like a millimeter out of place on the live gamer portable. And because of that, it was ruining everything. Like, I barely even nudged it. And it fixed everything. So mad! So anyway, basically I wanted to tell you guys, what is this? The Japanese boys, what about the girls? Noon on 5-2 and lasting until 5-12. Okay. Let's just hop over there now. So anyway, what I wanted to initially say, what this beginning of this video was supposed to goddamn well be, I'm assuming there's not going to be anybody. These are probably going to be mostly Japanese. I am going to be trying to make an effort from this point forward on Saturdays and Sundays to be playing BlazBlue from about noon to 2 p.m. Pacific time. So that'd be like 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern time. I can never remember. It's Central time. It's 2 hours ahead of me. So 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Central time. I believe the other one's called like Mountain Standard Time, the one that nobody ever uses. It's always either Pacific, Central, or Eastern. Nobody ever talks about Mountain Standard Time, but that's 1 hour in front of me, so that'd be 1 to 3 if you're somewhere around there. So I will be trying to make an effort to be online if you want to play me, because I have been getting, you know, obviously requests and whatnot. Hey, can you play me? Blah, 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 whatever. So if you want to play me, I will try to be around at those times. Like, weekdays are too hectic to, like, be able to say, yes, I will be here at this time. There's too much up in the air to be able to commit to something like that. But this is generally around the time when I get off of work. So there should be no problems being around for this little bit of time every single week. So I'm just letting y'all know, if you want to play me, that will be the time to do so. If you do want to play me, I will basically be... Wow, really? The fuck? Maybe they're all here. Like, maybe they're just... You know, American Second Lobby? Please? No. Maybe I won't be here from noon to two. Maybe I should try a different time that's later, because holy shit. Really? This may be... this check ranked? No, nobody really here either. Turbo lover. Nice. Nice. Ah, let's go! Fuck. Ah, let's go! Ah, yeah.
Here comes a new challenger.
Basic rules. First to three. You know, best three out of five set, unless nobody else in a certain amount of time has bothered to, try to connect to me, and then I'll just play you as long as possible until somebody's like, hey, can we play? But I just, you know, when I did this in Marvel, I did first to fives, but BlazBlue is obviously a lot longer matches than Marvel. So if you do, you know, give me a request, keep in mind you may have to wait for a while. I may have just started a best of three against somebody, or a first to three, god damn it, against somebody else. You never know. But that's going to be the basic rule.
Bring it on, you monster.
Alright, let's see if I can get 5 out of 5.
Rebel 1, action!
Bring it!
Fuck. No instant blocking for me. Yo, this is not 3 bars. You 3 bars. Chill out. Here. 3 bars. I'm offended. Chill out. Shit, that beat my 2A. I can't break my streak on a bad. This is the, you promised me 3. You promised me 3 bars. You're lying. Yeah, thanks for the growler. Appreciate that one. Jesus Christ, come on! I'm sorry, this is a terrible connection. I apologize profusely. Nobody deserves to be seeing this shit, but this is a good fucking start. God damn it. Block it.
Weak. Too easy. Weak. Idiot. Weak.
Nice Inferno Divider. I'm so sorry. Like, why? Ugh, I even reset my router before I did this. Like, I purposefully. Bullshit! You don't get to rank up after you lose? Come on, son! But anyway. Ugh. I reset my router before I start, just in an attempt to stave off what happened last time. I reset my router, and then like, the more that match went on, the worse the connection got. And there were just points, I mean, there's only a certain amount of lag I can blame on the other person. That one felt like the other person had wireless. I can't confirm that, obviously, without actually asking them. But just how it was going back and forth between this connection is fine to this connection sucks balls, that is usually an indication of a wireless connection, which sucks. Wireless connections are just atrocious for fighting games. They're so unreliable. See, and I come in here and it tells me it's a one bar. Don't give me that shit. Yeah, see, I don't understand how there's only, really only two people. Fuck. This hurts me. This hurts me. Let's just go check this shit out again. Like, I mean, because obviously it doesn't show you a lot of the connections initially. It only shows you the ones of people that are not currently in matches. Because obviously, if it was trying to match your connection against everybody else's that was in the middle of a match, it would be fucked up. It would fuck you up while you were in the middle of that match. Because obviously it's testing your connection against other people. And you don't want that at all. You want to only be connected to the one other person. But still, god damn. That's so disappointing. Yeah, Zero is Chester is Zero too. We don't even get to see if Chester is a Zero. We never get to see shit. I'm so sorry. That sounds like... Come on. Well, if it's taking this long to bring up an indicator... But that means the connection's going to suck. Fuck. This is so depressing. Like, I see a three-bar connection and I'm so fucking happy. And then, I mean, that had to be wireless. Well, shit. I mean, hopefully, since everybody except for you fucking Kyvel ruining lives and shit. But hopefully this, because I actually know this Hatsune Miku. I don't actually know them, but I recognize the gamer tag. I've seen them around. I know they imported it. They've always, every single time I've seen them, they've been a three-bar connection. So hopefully, that means this will be a good lobby for us to be in. Crossing our fucking fingers. Oh god, I'm so mad that was the first match we played. I was looking so forward, I just saw three bars and I was like, yes! Fixing all the problems, nope. So anyway, let's talk about how mad I am at life right now. You know how mad I am at life right now? Very mad at life right now. So I kind of talked about this a little bit, about how I've basically been hopping back and forth. I've just been very indecisive in terms of what major I want to do. See, the problem is, in the first place, it barely even matters what major you graduate, like what kind of degree you graduate with. For the majority of jobs, like there are some. If you want to be a lawyer, you better get a fucking law degree. If you want to be a doctor, you better get a motherfucking medical degree. There are certain professions where it is vital to get a certain degree. But for most of them, it's just like, oh, does this person have a degree? Yes or no. They don't even look at what kind of degree it is. You could be going into like financing, and you could have an art degree and like, yeah, hey, you got a college degree, good enough for me. But so basically I have finally settled on computer science. Now there's still a bunch of different types of computer science. You got shit like networking, database shit, just programming stuff in general. You know, you got all the different languages. You got Java, C, C++, Perl, Python, fucking millions of different languages out there, and there's the barest differences between all of them. But anyway, you got all of that stuff, and then the one that I think I might want to do is get into game development programming. The problem with that is the game, like, if you just look at news, at game news sites, all the time you just see that basically a bunch of them are, like, contracted workers. There's really no guaranteed job for a lot of people. And so, you know, you're constantly seeing these stories of, like, oh, EA laid off, you know, 60 employees at this place because, you know, the game's over and they don't need them anymore for the moment. You know, Activision did it. Rockstar did it. You know, is it Rockstar Games? I kind of got Rocksteady and Rockstar mixed up in my head for a little bit. I know they're completely different studios. But anyway, You know, you see these stories all the time, so it's a very... It's not a good... I'm not sure how good it is to get into for a, to, like, settle down with. Because it seems very random. Doesn't seem very consistent. And so that aspect scares me, and I need to get into it a lot more. But anyway, point of the story, I'm mad at it. Because I found out, since I have just, you know, decided I'm going to stick with this. This is going to be my major. So I finally started to look into all the classes I would need to take. You know, the higher levels of programming classes. And discovered that basically after this one that I am taking this semester, I am stonewalled. I have to start taking a calculus class, and there's, I can't remember, you have to do 2 levels of calculus or 3 levels of calculus. I know there's, it's either 2 levels of calculus and 2 levels of physics, or 3 levels of calculus and 1 level of physics. I can't remember exactly which, but point is, I cannot continue on with programming until I take this one single math class, and I am so sad, because that basically means, and this is all on me too, if I had just looked further down the line, I would have seen that and taken that class this semester, and I would not have that problem. But next semester, for me, is basically just a waste. I have that one class that I can take, and the rest of them are all, nope, can't take any of these, sorry. Yeah, let's go Power of Justice, show the power of Bullet!
No!
Yeah, should have grabbed again.
You had the right idea the first time.
Oh, that's cool. This Hatsune Miku dude's on the mic helping people. Shoutouts to you, homie. People like you are good people. Unlike me, who I just sit in the background and talk shit about people. That was a bad idea. Even if that worked, that was a bad idea. You just wasted meter to get... Oh, fuck, it's a best 3 out of 5. This is gonna take forever. Anyway, that was a good idea. I mean, that was not a good idea. It was not a good use of resources. See, if he had kept those resources... But if the dude had kept those resources, he would have won on that second hit right there. Instead of using them, because that super would not have killed. I'm fairly certain, even if that was an overdrive, which it wasn't, overdrive wore off first. But even if it was an overdrive move, it still would not have killed. And so you never want to spend a 50 meter on a distortion. Well, I should not say never, because there are a lot of characters that, they end their combos in positions that are not exactly the most advantageous of positions. Oh, why did you not follow it up? That was so much damage. And so spending 50 meter on distortion gives you a better knockdown, gives you better OP, whatever. So that sometimes it's useful, but not off a bullet. Ouch. You probably could have followed that up. Ah, oh, I don't care. Oh, well, never mind. I forgot. If this was a 2 out of 3, that would have been a terrible burst. But 3 out of 5, that's worth it. Yeah. I don't know. Why do all the platinum players use it on Cat Staff? It just seems like there's so many better options to use that super off. Oh, I just realized this homie's using English Bullet. Never actually heard English Bullet before. Ouch. Oh, terrible! Terrible! 3C in the Mikulet capture, son! Please, you're level 15, you gotta represent correctly! Platinum's not bad though. The main cut, nice. Oh, I was gonna say, is that some knockdown? Yo, give me. Aww! Oh. Yes! Phoenix Infinites! I had no idea if that would work, but I was so excited when I saw him do overdrive. I was like, that has to be what's happening. Phoenix Infinites! But that's the problem with, Platinum in general, she actually does have very solid pressure. She has good mix-up, and she has decent normals. It's just, outside of the corner, her options are so limited. Her damage and everything is so incredibly limited. But once she gets in the corner, she is a scary individual. That sucks. Oh, that was good shit. Oh, not good shit. You suck. I mean, I don't know what it could actually. Probably could have ended that with a cat staff. Yeah, there it is. But I think you could have ended that combo with a cat staff to win. It might have just been lag.
For sure, man.
Because that match did not look. And obviously, this dude is a one bar, so it's entirely possible that connection was not entirely perfect. Still, it's nice to see a platinum. It's nice to see a good player playing platinum. Because I'll be honest, man, the character diversity. I mean, I haven't been online a lot since the American version dropped, so I can't really say with 100% guarantee that character diversity is just not there. But, come on. There we go. In terms of before the game dropped, there was no character diversity at all. It was basically, I mean, like, well, see, now we're getting into it. It's just Hatsune Miku that is fucking it all up. Plenty of Ragna.
Tony, what do you mean?
Plenty of Jin, plenty of Noelle. There weren't really many of other. Oh, Hazuma and Terumi are all over the place, too. There weren't that many of anybody else. Because there are a few dedicated NorCal players that I know the gamer tags of that have been playing since, you know, since I have in CS. And so you have, like, I would have to see their names to remember them. But, like, there's, you know, a dedicated Lychee player that I know. That's pretty much it. Rin Harasaki plays a lot, and he usually uses Mew. I don't know if he still specifically sticks with Mew or not. Terrible. Come on, Rampage, Kako. Don't want a real Rampage. Oh, never mind. Not close enough to the corner to matter. Wonder why he doesn't use 2-2-C. That is the move, though. But 2-2-C is the little kind of spring move, right?
Put your mind in.
Oh, come on, dog! Oh, okay. He needs to pick those combos up, though. Actually, I'll be right back. I want to go get that drink. Alright, we're back! Yo, that command grab range. I need to find out if she actually auto-tracks. Like, she'll just keep going until she reaches you. Or if it does have a limit. Stop it. Stop it. You can't fuck with that move. It's too good. You have to respect it. You absolutely have to respect that move. It's too good. Aw, you could pick that up, huh? Poor Rampage Taco.
Yeah!
Really? She really calls him a pedo? Really?
Are you just getting dressed or are you gonna go?
Really, Platinum? Really? So that's how you do? Man, we've gone almost 30 minutes. It's going to be 30 minutes. Oh my god, we still have two more people to go through. Before we even get to me. It's gonna be like 35 minutes since this is 3 out of 5. Before we get to me. Holy shit. No! Go away! Jeez! Good. Thank God. Ah, I hate that guy. Dude, it's just a lag monstering Jin. It absolutely sucks playing against him. Because he always joins. I don't know why. He always joins the West Coast rooms. Like, he'll join the West Coast streaming rooms, Koopa's room. What's his name? What? Y isn't working? Hit A, dog. Yay! Yay! Too bad, son. Get a new controller. We're getting closer to me. I cursed your controller, dog.
Pressing X. It got stuck.
Holy shit, how long does it fucking take? Does it take like another 5 minutes just while before the person starts blinking? It should be like 30 seconds. Once somebody starts fucking blinking before they get bypassed. This is stupid.
T-shirts. Episode 36 of Pokemon.
Seriously, this is legit. Blaze Blue, please. Bro.
Still nothing.
Damn, that took ages. Why did that take so fucking long?
All right.
No! Yeah, this dude actually picks Azrael. I'm not picking Azrael. Who will I pick?
I'll be back on.
Should I go with Tager? Fuck it, I'll go with Tager. I am not doing Azrael. I hate Azrael mirrors. I need to just pick a counter pick to Azrael. Hazuma. Hazuma really is a counter pick to Azrael, and that sucks. Cause I'm not gonna learn Hazuma. I should just pick up Tao.
Akaoni.
This is gonna suck. 3 out of 5 rounds with Tager against Azrael. Look. This is a bad. Why did I just try to 5A? I guess I probably could have mirror matched this guy. He's not all that good. Damn. I was hoping he would come right in. He didn't. I'm Taker sucks. Just in case y'all wanted to know. That really just anti-air my fucking file. Oh wow, I can't believe that actually got my roll. Good shit. I deserve nothing. You motherfucker! I need to learn how to pick that up. I'm not picking it up at all.
Rebel 4, action!
This dude's hit confirmed, bro. Tager. This dude's hit confirmed, bro. Tager. I was both footsies.
That
was... Everybody knows that was 720. That was 720. I won. Regardless of what happens in this next match, I won. Everybody knows! Motherfucker, come on, dude. That was a super jump. Damn it! I'm free! Did y'all see those godlike combos? I'm free. My Tager is free. God damn, I suck. If that dude had any concept of proper movement on me, I would have been fucked. The only reason is because this dude had no neutral game whatsoever. Damn. We just drove out everybody. At least that connection didn't suck, yay! That dude just break. That homie just broke. Oh, never mind, no he didn't. Person not here to play. Dick. We finally found good connections, and then everybody up and fucking leaves. I hate my life. I really legitimately hate my life. It's the only everybody really just quit. Cause there are no other good connections available. I'm so sad right now. I got abandoned! I don't want to join a one bar, like, we already had a 3-bar room that the connection sucked in ranked. I don't want to go do. Yo, everybody's gone. What happened? Holy shit, are you real? Is that really? I really hope that's actually Zong 1. Alright, I'm gonna start a new video for this one. But oh my god, I will be hype as fuck if that is Zong 1. You have no idea.